Your name is?
Adib Gobriel.
And where are you from?
Originally from Egypt. I've been here in the United States for 42 years.
Your profession?
I'm a businessman.
When Professor Mordechai Kadarg came on Al Jazeera and spoke truth in Arabic, how did that resonate with the Christians, Christian Arabs?
Well, with the Christian, he resonates very, very well, and he speaks the truth 100%. But for the Muslims, different story. But he speaks Arabic fluently, fluently. Everybody understands him, like was one of us.
How well do you think he understands the situation that the Christians are facing in the Arab world?
Well, he understands it very well, and he understands the Muslim more than the Christian, because he's studying more Muslim than Christian. But we are in the same boat, Christian and the Jewish. We are in the same boat. We born both. They hate us. They persecute us. And so we are in the same boat. That's why I'm thinking to have a TV station from here, from Los Angeles, and speak to the Arab world, the Muslim, especially the Muslim, to show them that Israel is not their enemy. The enemy comes from within, not Israel.
From within where?
From themselves, their Quran. They hate each other. They want to kill each other. As he explained it here, that they kill more Arab, Muslim, killing Muslim, more than they think the Jewish state. Jewish state killed maybe like, 1% for defense, not for killing, defense.
What is life like for the Christians in Egypt?
Oh, very bad, very bad, especially, now, after the Brotherhood took over, very, very bad. And thanks to Obama that he supported the Muslim Brotherhood and they put them in power. The matter of fact, the other guy that who wants democratic country, he won by 500,000 vote. His name, Ahmed Shafiq.
So if he won, how did he not take power?
Because United States, at that time, the army was in control. The Egyptian army was in control of the country, and they told the army that they put Morsi as the president.
What agenda do you think President Obama has for Egypt?
Well, it's not just for Egypt, for the whole Middle East. Obama does not care about democracy, does not care about Christian. I believe he's more Muslim than Christian, and that's why he's supporting them.
Do you suppose he has an agenda for the whole Middle East?
Well, the saying in the Middle East, saying that he had a deal with the Brotherhood to resolve the Israeli-Palestinian problem, and they gave them, I think, that's personal, I think, too, that the Brotherhood made a deal with Obama that put us in power and will resolve the problem of Palestinian, and they will give part of the Sinai Desert to the Palestinian, and they will have their own state. If this is true or not, I don't know, but a lot of people said that in Egypt.
What is life like for Christians under the Palestinians?
The same way as the Christian under the Muslim Brotherhood, because the Hamas is part of or part of the Brotherhood, and they like one entity. That's why Morsi now supporting the, and after the war started, in by telephone, one phone call, they agreed about the ceasefire. I mean, from the Hamas point of view.
How about life for the Christians in Bethlehem and in Nazareth?
Well, I visited Israel. The Christian there is, they have no problem. I mean, if I have the choice to live in Egypt or Israel, I'll go to Israel. I live in Israel.
But are the Christians under the Palestinian Authority in the West Bank, like say Bethlehem, Nazareth, are they being persecuted?
You mean other, under the Muslim or under?
Under the Muslims.
Oh yes, sure, they are persecuted. Yeah, everywhere, the Christian everywhere under Muslim control, they are persecuted.
If the Palestinians were given a sovereign state, what would be the fate of the Christians, do you feel?
Well, same as like in Egypt or Iraq or every other country. When I visited Egypt, I met few Arab, they have a citizenship, Israeli citizenship. And I asked him, I said, if you have a state, Palestinian has a state, would you go back? He said, no, I will never leave Israel. I'll have more democracy here than if we have a Palestinian state. I was surprised.
Professor Kadar, how accurate do you think his statements were here today?
100% accurate. 100% accurate.
Do you feel that he's biased because he's Jewish?
No. He understands the Middle East very well. No, he's not biased. He's telling the truth.
Why do you suppose he isn't given more exposure on American media?
Well, I was asking myself this question. Why the American media, they're not talking or protecting Israel or defending Israel or saying even the truth, not defending, just the truth.